Hello, good morning everybody. In this tutorial, we are going to make the state machine and the hitbox. As you can see, I implemented the platforms. I'm not going to show it in the video. If you are interested, check my tutorial about platforms. But anyway, the platforms don't affect the rest of the game at all, so it's not necessary to add them. Let's start implementing the state machine. Go to the player scene we made in the last video and add a script for the state machine node. First of all, define the stage using an enum. The player will have 4 stages: idle, run, attack, and dead. Create an integer variable called state that stores the current state of the player. Initialize it to -1 to indicate that at the start it doesn't have any state. Also, add an onReady variable for the player to access his properties. Create a function called getTransition that returns an integer. This function will tell us if the player has to switch state. Match the state variable. If we are in the idle state and the velocity have a length superior to 5, return the run state. If we are in the run state and the player has a velocity inferior than 5, return the idle state. If we are in the attack state and the animation player is not playing, return the idle state. If the animation player is not playing, it means that the attack ended. If none of these conditions match, return -1 to indicate the player must not switch state. Next, create another function, enterState, with a parameter indicating the new state. We will execute this function every time the state changes, so it's a good place to change the animations. With the help of a match statement, play the corresponding animation at each state. When we enter the dead state, set can move to false too, to disable the movement of the player. Now, to change the state, add a setter to the state variable and create the setter function. At the start of the function, check if the new value is different than the current value. If they are the same, we don't need to do anything, since we already are in that state. So, if they are different, assign the new value to the state variable and call the enterState function with the new value. This way, the animations will change automatically when we change the state. To make the state machine work, we have to call the getTransition function periodically to check if we should change the state. Let's do it in the PhysicsProcess function. Store the result of the getTransition function in a variable called transition. If the value of transition is -1, the state should not change, so check it with an if. If transition is different than -1, call the setState function with the value of the transition to switch to the new state. The state machine is based on the one GameEndeavor made. The function names and the logic is the same, but I simplified it because we only need a state machine for the player. Finally, open the player script and switch the state to idle when the player is ready. If you play the game now, the idle and run animations should work. The attack animation is not working and I got a warning. The warning just tells me to add an underscore before delta, if I don't plan to use it. So let's add it. As for the attack animation, we have to change the state to attack when the player presses the attack button. Open the player script one more time and add an if at the end of the getInput function. If the player just presses the UI attack input action, set the state to the attack state. When the state machine enters the attack state, it will play the attack animation. The isActionJustPressed function only returns true if we were not pressing the action in the previous frame. So I cannot keep the button pressed to attack non-stop. If you want to attack all the time without releasing the key, use is action pressed instead. This function will only check if the key is pressed this frame. If we press the attack key, we will be able to attack now. Let's continue making the hitbox. But before, a little tip. You can make the Godot editor full screen if you press Shift F11. If you press the keys again, you will exit the full screen mode. Create a new script for the hitbox node and connect the body entered signal to it. If the body that entered the hitbox is not the player himself, call the damage function of the body to apply the damage. Pass the damage you want to deal as the argument. That's it, as simple as that. To test the hitbox, print the name of the player who entered the hitbox. We cannot test it visually yet because the base character does not have a state machine, so we could not tell when it dies. And we cannot instance another player, since it will use the same case to move an attack as old player. So until we implement the online part, the only way to see if the hitbox works is using a debug message. Let's test it at the base character somewhere in the game. To see when the hitbox is enabled, enable the Visible Collision Saves option in the debug options. Try to attack. We can see that the hitbox is enabled when we attack, but the hitbox detects all players in addition to the base character. Let's check the hitbox script. Oh, I compared self to the body. But self does not represent the player, represents the hitbox. So the if will return always true. To fix it, create an already variable for the player, the parent of the hitbox. And instead of using self, use this variable. It should work now. We are comparing the player of the hitbox with the character the hitbox collided with. It should not collide anymore with our player. Let's test the game one last time. Now, as we can see in the output, the hitbox only collides with the other character. With that, we have the basic gameplay down. From now on, I will focus on networking. If you want, you can try to improve the gameplay on your own. In the next video, I will start making the menu where the players will be able to create or choose a room to join. But before, I have to do some cleanup.